Hello friends, today we are going to start with the first chapter of yours, which is force and turning effect of force. So what is force? See, most of the things which we are going to do in this physics, in this class, will be continuing from what you have already been done in your junior classes. So we are going to start with the first topic, which is force. Now, what is force? We know that force is a cause which can change the state of rest or state of motion or state of direction of a body. So it is basically a cause which changes, it not always changes, it sometimes also tends to change. That means the force is being applied, the body is not changing its state of rest, but it is trying to do so. So tends to change. What? Three things: either state of rest, second one state of motion, and third one state of direction. So let's go one by one. First of all, how can a force change the state of rest? Suppose this object is stationary, it is at rest. So when a force is applied on it, it will start moving. Or if I throw it, so the force is being applied on the body and the body starts moving. That is called, it can change the state of rest. Now what is state of motion? We are already implicating the laws of inertia into this, because we have our understanding clear about inertia. What was inertia? Inertia is inability of a body to move by itself. And that is why the laws of force, that is Newton's laws of motion, are starting with the laws of inertia. So inertia is basically inability of a body to move by itself. Alright, so this inertia thing has already been inculcated into the fact of force. That is, when the body was at rest, that means it is at inertial phase. It's not moving, so when the force is applied, the body will start moving. Alright. Similarly, state of motion. Suppose there is an object. Initially, we took this case when the object was initially at zero, force was applied on it, and the object started moving. Second case, the object is already moving with some initial velocity of u meter per second. Let's say a force of F Newton has been applied on the body. So what will happen? The body might change its velocity. The body might increase or decrease. Change in velocity has to be there, definitely. But in what sense? The velocity can also get increased, the velocity can also get decreased, because that thing depends on the direction of force. Suppose I apply the force in this direction, if it is in supporting nature, it will increase the velocity. Whereas if it is in opposing nature, it will decrease the velocity. So it will be, now it will be moving with v meter per second. So that is why I am not saying that v is greater than u or less than u. It will just depend on the nature of force applied on the body. So the velocity will change. That is what we mean by state of motion is going to change. Lastly, state of direction. Suppose a body is moving in this direction and the force is acting on body in this direction. So ultimately the body will start moving in this direction, right? That is what it is called as state of direction. So these are three changes which a force can bring upon. So how do we measure force? Force is measured by the formula given by what? Newton's laws of motion? Yes, but we also need to know the SI unit of force. So SI unit of force is, we all know it very well, this is Newton's. So 1 Newton, according to formula, F is equal to ma, though we are going to go for the derivation of this formula in a while. So according to this formula, F is equal to ma, 1 Newton is 1 kg times 1 meter per second square. So how can we define 1 Newton? When a force acting on 1 kg makes an acceleration of 1 meter per second square in the body, then the force acting on it is called 1 Newton. Or when a force acts on a body of 1 kg such that its acceleration becomes 1 meter per second square, then the force is said to be 1 Newton. You can rephrase it any way you like it. Now, there are CBSE units of force as well. Has to be. So after SI unit, we need to know the CBSE unit. What is the CBSE unit? It is called dynes. CGS unit is dyne. And how to convert dyne? This is 1 dyne is equal to, instead of kg, I am getting 1 gram times 1 centimeter per second square. Because in CGS system, we use centimeter, grams and second. Whereas SI unit follow MKS system. What is MKS? Meter, kilogram and second. So 1 dyne is equal to 1 gram times 1 centimeter per second square. So similarly, when a force acting on a body of mass 1 gram such that it moves with an acceleration of 1 centimeter per second square, then the force acting is said to be 1 dynes. Okay. Are there any other units of force? Yes, there are. That is called gravitational unit of force. So what is gravitational unit of force? It is the force by which Earth attracts the body. So this is represented as either 1 kgf or 1 gf. 1 kilogram force or 1 gram force. 1 kilogram force can be converted into newtons by multiplying the same quantity by 9.8, which is acceleration due to gravity. So this is 9.8 newtons now. And similarly, 1 gram force can be similarly converted into this thing, newtons or dynes, right? For dynes, I'll be multiplying it by 980 centimeter per second square. Whereas for newtons, I'll be multiplying it with the 9.8, okay? So this is force, and these are various SI units, other systems of force.